Hi there. A lot of conspiracy theories deal with something that they call New World Order. And when you look at Wikipedia, you will find that there are two articles dealing with the term New World Order. The first article, I'll just say the first, is about the New World Order in politics. The term NWO in politics, and the other one is about the term NWO in conspiracy theories. That shows that in politics, the NWO is, well, not really a concept, but there are concepts, plural, that promulgate a new world order. For example, the Nazis were talking about the new world order, the communists also did so, the Bushes, George Bush the first and the George Bush the second, they were both talking about the new world order. Now, it could be funny to try to compare these three, the communists, the Nazis and the Bushes, to each other to find out what do they have in common. But I think that would be something for someone like George Carlin or Bill Hicks. I think they would do a much better job in comparing these three. now when you listen to these conspiracy theorists, you should keep in mind the three basic steps that you should always keep in mind when dealing with conspiracy theories. Step 1. From what perspective are they talking? From what's their point of view? Step 2. Who are they pointing at? Who are they accusing and of what? Most of the time, point 1 and point 2 are connected. Fundamentalist Christians will point at someone that they call Satanists, even if they are not Satanists. But they'll just call them Satanists, because that's a Christian term and it's great to denounce everyone that you don't like. Some racist would just point at the Jews, and Muslims will also point at the Jews, and some capitalists will point at the communists or the socialists. So point 1 and point 2 are most of the time tied together. Point 3 is, what are they not mentioning? What are they leaving out? What are they just ignoring? And most of the time they're ignoring facts, lots of facts. When I talk about Freemasonry in a episode to come, I will show you some examples for mechanisms that will illustrate these three steps, these three points in dealing with conspiracy theories. But when it comes to the NWO, well, point 1. There are, for example, people like Alex Jones and the like, people from the Christian corners, from the Christian, different Christian groups, and sometimes even Muslims, and they are using most of the time something that makes people afraid of losing their religion. Now I remember the great old song from R.E.M., Losing My Religion. And of course Christians are terrified by the thought of losing their religion. That's why they promote intelligent design. Not all of them are promoting intelligent design and that bullshit, but some of them are, and even some Muslims are. They are afraid of losing their religion because their religion gives them an identity, and identity is great when you have a weak individuality. Identity is like a wheelchair. It can carry you wherever you want to go, when you're not able to go. Capitalists, when they are, I don't know if there are capitalists talking about the NWO, but if there are capitalists talking about the NWO, you will also see that they are talking against things that they just dislike naturally. And it's always the same. You see, conspiracy theories basically work like this. They are presenting some facts to you, and then they present a conspiracy theory to you that tries to glue together all these facts to become one big coherent picture. But the problem is that each of these facts is true, otherwise they wouldn't be facts. But they are not promoting the conspiracy theory. You see, you can see that everywhere when conspiracy theories are mentioned. People are saying, the Freemasons are doing this, the Freemasons are doing that, and then they point at some video game or something like that and say, look, there are Masonic symbols, and they are ignoring the fact that the Masons took these symbols from somewhere else. So maybe the designers of the video game took them from Masonry, maybe they took them from somewhere else. You see those pictures in the background, they are my own work. There are these checker thingies. That doesn't mean I'm a Mason, just because I'm painting these. Not everyone who's playing checkers or chess is a Mason because they are playing a game where a black and white square pattern is used. That's basic logic. You see, Aristotle was a philosopher, Aristotle was a man, but that doesn't mean that every man is a philosopher. Basic logic. And before I start ranting too much here, I'll end this video. I mentioned these basic three steps, and as I said, these basic three steps will return in this series. They are very important. They are very important when dealing with conspiracy theories. So, have a nice Saturnalia and enjoy yourself.